Hey, what's going on everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox tutorial. Today we're going to be covering PS3 using an awesome emulator known as RPCS3. And by the way, I mean it's always been possible to import our PS3 games into Launchbox and Big Box, but with the latest updates to Launchbox, i.e. 13.3, we've kind of made the process a lot easier. So really, the issue came down to when importing your PS3 games, we had to manually select our eBoot files in order for Launchbox to know what game we have. But with the latest revision of Launchbox, it'll automatically detect all of those files for us and get them in the correct location. Now, there are a few steps to get this up and running, and I'm going to walk you through most of it. What I'm going to do here is show you a basic setup of the RPCS3 emulator, and then I'll show you how to import everything properly. So if you're ready to get started, let's go ahead and jump into it. So the first thing you're going to need here are some PS3 games. I've got a few in a folder called PS3 right on my desktop. I've just went through with three of them to make the import and tutorial much easier. We've got Demon's Souls, Ninja Gaiden, Persona 5. The best practice here would be place these in your Launchbox games directory. Now that's if you want to keep everything portable, because these games can get quite large. And if we try to copy the files over during the import, it might not work out very well. So I would go ahead and put these exactly where you want them to stay. But with the newest revisions of Launchbox, we can automatically get this set up. So I've got my games here. I'm just going to be importing these three. Next thing we need to do is get the PS3 emulator set up in Launchbox. So from Tools, we're going to head to Manage, Emulators. We're going to add a new emulator. Moving over to Emulator Name, from the dropdown, we're actually going to find RPCS3. Right over here, we've got a little dynamic link that's going to bring us right over to the website. We can download the emulator here. So we definitely want to go with the Windows version. It's going to ask us. We'll grab this. And one of the most important things here with this PS3 emulator is PS3 firmware. You can actually download this from the official Sony website. They've changed it up a bit from the past, but it's still easy to download. Update using a computer. Download PS3 update. We need to install this firmware in RPCS3. Now that we have the emulator downloaded and the PS3update.pup, we're going to go ahead and extract RPCS3. I use WinRAR, but you could use 7-zip if you want to. And inside of our RPCS3 folder we just extracted, we've got all of these files, including the RPCS3.exe. So I personally like to keep my Launchbox completely portable. So what I'm going to do is place this in my emulators folder. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy this. I'm going to head to my Launchbox install directory, which just happens to be on an external drive, emulators. And I'm just going to put it right in here. That way, if I ever want to move Launchbox to a different PC, everything's right there ready to go. Now, before moving back over to Launchbox, I highly recommend doing our initial setup with RPCS3. So we're going to go right here to our .exe. We're going to launch the application, and it's actually super easy to do, gives us a nice walkthrough. And one thing I can't stress enough is if you get stuck, head over to the RPCS3 wiki page. There is so much information over there. If somebody else has run into that issue, there's a fix on the wiki. I'm going to go ahead and select both of these and we'll continue. It does have an automatic updater, so we can update if we want to. And this is our RPCS3 interface, the standalone PS3 emulator. First thing we want to do is install the PS3 firmware we downloaded from the official Sony website. File, install firmware, and we're going to navigate to where that firmware is located. Mine's still in my downloads folder, PS3update.pup, and it's now going to install the firmware. It also needs to compile the PPU modules. This could take a little while depending on how fast your CPU is, but just give it time, it'll finish up. Once the firmware is installed, we're going to set up our controller, and then we can move right back over to Launchbox. Now that our firmware is installed, we're going to head to our pad section right up here. From the dropdown, you want to choose your controller. So I'm using an Xbox controller. I'm going to go X input. Our device list will give us a list of all of the controllers we have connected. Now we can actually test the controller. If you take a look here, we've got that left analog stick moving. And personally, I like the default config that they've got set up for basically any controller I've ever tested with it. But you can manually map this if you want to. I find the default works out great. We'll choose save. And now we can close the RPCS3 emulator. We've got our controller set up and our firmware installed. From the Add Emulator section in Launchbox, Application Path, we're going to navigate to our Launchbox directory, Emulators, and we'll find RPCS3. We want to choose the RPCS3.exe. Default command line parameter is already set up for us. Our sample commands are already set up. Associated platforms is ready to go. This is only for PS3, so this is going to be our default emulator. We'll choose OK, Close. Now we have the emulator set up. Last thing we need to do is import our PS3 games. From Tools, Import, ROM Files, and we're going to navigate to where we have our PS3 games located. I'm going to add that full PS3 folder that I have on my desktop. We'll choose Next. Platform is going to be PlayStation 3. Emulator, RPCS3. And with this section, go ahead and choose Use the games in their current location. Like I mentioned earlier, copy them over to your Launchbox games directory. That way you have them all ready to go and you can keep Launchbox nice and portable. We want to download metadata for our games. Artwork, we'll leave everything checked here. And we don't need to specify any custom options. So we'll choose Next, and you'll see now with the latest versions of Launchbox, it automatically chose only the game or the bin file that we need to run this PS3 game with. In the past, if we didn't manually select it, it would give us a list of 100 different files to choose from. Persona 5, Ninja Gaiden, and Souls. We'll choose Finish. It's going to import our games, download our metadata, and our artwork, and once it's finished, over on the left-hand side, we'll have a new PlayStation 3 platform. It's got all three of my games imported, got some nice box art. Now it's time to start playing our favorite PS3 games. I'm going to go with Souls. And there you have it. It's now easier than ever to get PS3 up and running with Launchbox and Big Box. And by the way, we've also done kind of the same thing with Wii U, but that uses RPX files. I did a tutorial on it if you're interested. But that's going to wrap it up for this one. We really appreciate you watching and hope you enjoy using Launchbox and Big Box. We've always got new stuff on the way, so keep an eye on the YouTube channel and the forum. But like always, thanks for watching.